So I hope this makes sense to you. Try it out. The next time you start working on a fresh new project.
Hey guys, welcome. It's a busy, busy day and I'm already really, really late. Ooh, I hate when that is messed up. Come on. Okay, I got it. First up, visiting Justus in his studio. We need to record a couple of guitar bits for two new songs I haven't shared yet. And two other songs that are this close to being finished. So there are a lot of releases coming up.
So the songs I'm wrapping up at the moment, one of them is called Love or Let Go. It's finished 100%. But I want to try out if a guitar might fit in there or not. It's like, that's like my approach to music production. I always try things out and see if they work. If they don't work, it kind of narrows it down to the only or best possibility for the song, for the vocal. And guitar, I haven't tried. So I'm curious if it works, good. If not, also good. I'm saying it's
made it to the studio. I got absolutely no time, so for lunch just corn and chickpeas and nothing else. There's so little time today actually. Whoa! Okay, it's just corn. The chickpeas just exploded for no reason. It smells really bad. I think it like, but how? I mean, I just bought it anyways. But yeah, that's my lunch. Corn and a chili. Not bad. By the way, the recording session with the guitar we had was not a success. We recorded, jammed a little, tried things out, didn't work at all, didn't improve the song. So I just erased it and the song is ready. That's at least like one plus. Now eating my gourmet lunch, and then I got two Skype calls actually with two companies that want to work with me. That's good, but usually those Skype calls, they take like three times as long as expected, and I don't have the time for that. But once we're done with that, back to music making, 100% new song, very excited. Ah, these Skype calls. I don't get it. Like there are so many companies trying to get in touch with me and they want me to advertise for them, but I'm honestly not really interested in that. This channel is like a channel about my life as a DJ and producer. Yes, sometimes I make like a review or share some insights into something that is more like technical, but it's always something I anyways use, something I like so much that I want to share it with you. And paying me for just saying something that I don't believe in, it's just impossible. And these companies just don't get it. They're like, yeah, here, take a bunch of money. And I'm like, no, but I don't use the product. I can't recommend it. And they're like, yeah, here's more money. And I'm like, no, I can't. And I also don't want to read like just like a message like 1 minute within my video. I think it totally ruins the vibe of the video. So not doing that. There are a lot of other possibilities to support this channel right here. For example, sample packs, if you're interested, first link in the description. It's just $5 for all of my sample packs I ever created. And yeah, I also managed to make some music actually. And there's one thing I would love to share with you. It's something it took me a while to learn. And I'd say it's like my best approach in starting making new songs. And it's fairly simple, so I don't know why I never thought of it, but once you start doing it, it just makes so much sense. I'm pretty sure you're all familiar with this one problem. You start a new song, you get to a certain point, and then you realize the song sucks and you stop working on it. Or you get to a point where you can't solve it and turn it into a good song and you just stop. I avoid that completely by just like sketching drafts, like fast prototyping. I think that's like the right term for it. And fast prototyping just means I start working on a song just for half an hour to an hour, and then I start another song. And I sometimes do like 5 to 10 of them in one day, listen at the end of the day to all of them, and then trust me, it's so easy out of 10 to pick the one that has the most potential. It's then the best out of 10 ideas, and then it's all about like executing it and finishing it and making it a full song, a full ready song for release. So much easier. Just imagine you're taking your first idea and try to get it to the finish line. It will crumble, it won't work eventually. If you take the best out of 10, you get a lot better results. It's at the end a lot faster. For me personally, the idea phase, the beginning, is the most exciting. So doing that is actually fun. I love these days where I just jam around and try out different stuff. Well, let me give you an example of what I did today. Let me just play you like the bounced out audio stuff, because I'm actually not supposed to share this. That's a good top line, especially like the chorus part. And it's 115 BPM. I was first thinking about speeding it up, slowing it down, or keeping it at 115. I kept it at 115 because the vibe was the most natural. And then I first thought, because I want to do something new. I don't want to just open up my last project and just slap the vocal on top and have the next release ready. That's just not what I like to do. Just want to switch it up, change it up to keep it interesting for me and also for you. So I thought about why not go more into like an 80s kind of direction. I hear it a lot right now. I love it. Big snare, ARP sound, big bass. And that's what I tried out first. So let's listen to that version. For me, I wish I could love you better. I'd tell you what that's forever. If only it was that simple. Was that simple? I wish I could love you better. Very simple. Don't judge me based on that. It's not good, but it's just for me doing rough sketches, fast prototyping, to see if the direction I want to go is actually the right one. And it sounds okay. This works. It fits to the vocal. I could turn it into a full song. But what if? That's usually what I'm thinking about when I make music. I want to try out every possibility and then pick the one that is the right one. So let's listen to version number 2. I felt like trying to get it more to an electronic music direction and more clubby kind of. And that's what I got. I keep on playing. You're so damn perfect. So near heavenly. But maybe not for me. I wish I could love you better. Tell you would last forever. If only it was that simple. Was that simple. I wish I could love you better. Keep what we have together. Like more call response. Darker. A lot darker. And with this version, I felt like the instrumental is good, but it drifts away from the vocal, and it's not like a contrast that I like. It just doesn't feel connected. So this one, I might remove the vocal and try to get another vocal, or maybe just start arranging it, maybe speeding it up. I think for a clubby version, 120 plus BPM might be a lot better. And then the last version, I just wanted to try like... So many messages, come on. I just try to do something that I haven't done before in a different style, not related to anything. Just go with the flow of the vocal. Support it in the most natural way. Wish I could love you better. Tell you what that's forever. If only it was that simple. Was that simple? I wish I could love you better. Keep what we have together. And that's the one. Like, out of those three, they're all possible. They could all be like a fully finished song. But why spend all of the time and effort when not trying at the beginning already to pick the right one? And that's what I did here. 3 versions. For this one was enough. Sometimes I do 10. Sometimes I do just 1 and think it's all right. But I always like keep in mind that there is this possibility to make multiple versions at the very beginning, especially for vocal music, especially when you have the vocals at the very beginning and you're open to do whatever you want with them. Make sure you pick the right path. And I think right here for this vocal, it's the 3rd version. It has like this totally different beat. I usually never do, but it just fits so perfectly. And I think that could be like the most interesting
the one that supports the vocal the most, the one that like makes the most complete kind of song. And yeah, now it's just about finishing it, like just sound designing it, EQing it, mixing it, making every single element in there bigger and arranging it, making it interesting. But I think it's like the best starting point. So I hope this makes sense to you. Try it out. The next time you start working on a fresh new project, put a timer on 1 hour, 2 hours, then do another version, another version, another version. Then the day is over. Then listen to all of them, pick the best. And on the next day, you just continue working on that best one. It will save you so much time. You always will end up with better results at the end. And it's more likely that you will actually finish the song because you picked the best idea. And the idea is usually that one thing that makes the track. It's not the sound design, it's not the mixing, it's the idea. And if the idea is already bad, there is no point in finishing it and finalizing it because it will never get better. Even if you mix it, even if you sound design it, EQ it, if you master it, if you compress it, it doesn't help you if the idea isn't good. So first, the ideas. Jam. Fast prototyping. That's at least for me the method that gives me the best results, saves me the most time. So good luck making some music during the holiday season. You might have a lot more time to try out new stuff. Have fun. We'll see us tomorrow back again here in the studio. For me, there's one cable dangling there I still have to fix, and thinking about how to actually make this table work. All of that coming up probably tomorrow.